building this argument is that as if this is a very large principle that is, they have to be filled. The larger principle is perhaps representativeness, but to which we'll come later. But could I request you to read 51D, which is very instructive, and from that will flow the law and the rules. Usme aap zara padhiyega, and I want to make a comment on that, because I think that gives an answer. The rules will have to align with the.
And they are aligned to it in my submission, but let's read it. Members to the seats reserved for women which are allocated to a province under clause 3 shall be elected in accordance with law through proportional representation system political parties list of candidates on the basis of total number of general seats secured by each political party from the province concerned in the national
assembly. So my comment is that had this sub-article stopped at the word concern, things would have been as you say, that it remains within the political parties. But it says the seats, general seats secured by each political party from the province in the national assembly. So the denomination goes to the whole set, the whole house. Had in the national assembly not been there, my reading would be that then the matter could be resolved within the political party.
That will explain why province concerned in national assembly and why in case of E only in the national assembly has been used. There is a purpose, there is a reason, and why the term secured has also been used here. Just as Muneeb Akhtar had actually pointed out, in case of reserved seats for women in under paragraph B, each province shall be a single constituency for all reserved seats reserved for women which are allocated to the respective provinces. So
my point was simple, and maybe that's how I'm looking at it. I'm just saying that the total number of general seats that we need to understand ki political party ko kitna mila hai, the denomination is the total number of seats in the house from that province. Aap jo exclude karte hai na, the exclusion of independent doesn't flow from D. That's all I'm saying.
There is an inherent problem with what my lord, and with respect my lord, if I, there is an inherent problem there. And that problem is that if we apply what my lord has just observed, it will, in the case, it will, if there are an X number of independents,
yes,
which is equal to or more than the general seats required to fill in one reserve seat, if your approach is applied, then inevitably one or more reserve seats will remain vacant.
It's accentuated because of the fact of the independence being more. Otherwise, normally circumstance nahi arrive karega, lekin we still have to go to the text of the constitution.
Main to purpose aur text dono ko dekhe, main to khayal mein consistent hai. Let me just explain. Aaj ke numbers pe.
What my lord is asking, if the proviso is not included in D, उसका इफेक्ट ये होगा कि कोई भी इंडिपेंडेंट जो हुआ है वो फिर किसी पे ज्वाइन करे या ना करे, कोई इफेक्ट नहीं होगा उसको, वो सीट्स
सिर्फ
ओरिजिनल बोन सीट्स ऑफ द पार्टी will be in the formula.
That's right. And if I may take this further, let's for a moment assume that these 84 members or whatever the number who had joined the Sunni Ittehad Council have joined a political party. This then leaves us with 8 who have still retained independent status in this National Assembly. So in addition to this SIC, there are 8 who have retained independent status, including Mr. Gaur Ali Khan and several others.
Now, I just don't want to unnecessarily hammer on this point, but it's important because, you see, my problem with this is that the best way to solve this would be to have two set of calculations before us.
Gee.
One is excluding the independents and one not excluding the independent having the larger denomination.
Gee.
And see how does the voting pattern in the assembly changes. If it's drastic, then we have a problem.
Gee.
If it, well, I don't know what the difference is. So we'll have to see the difference. That difference then changes the scheme of things as far as representativeness is concerned, because the independents are also potent force within the assembly. They could be voting on things, they could join a political party tomorrow, they could do whatever. You cannot just think that independents are, you know, lesser beings in the assembly. So I think for me it would be very easy if you give me a calculation of the whole thing with excluding the independents and with the independents, what's the difference that comes about that could drastically change the way you have the voting pattern in the assembly, and that drastically affects the representativeness, which is, to my mind, still the larger principle.
Likewise, I think if
it is necessary, you see, there must be a chart.
मैं अभी आपको जरा एक लेके
जाऊंगा जी साहब, अगर आप इस क्वेश्चन आर्टिकल 59 पढ़ लें, जो सेनेट से मुताल्लिक है, सेनेट में तमाम मेंबर्स को वोट का हक दिया, इंक्लूडिंग द इंडिपेंडेंट्स, अगर आप ये दोनों मिला के पढ़ेंगे, देन आई थिंक देयर विल बी easier to understand.
Sir, aap pehla ek jo principle hai, when we talk about the role of independence, and I will give you the example of, ab hum ek province ko pick karenge, let's say we pick Punjab, province of Punjab,
for the
matlab aapka approach kuch mere approach se shayad fark hai. Mere hisab se to अंग्रेज़ी में लिखी हुई ये बात बहुत आसान है. हम पता नहीं कितने दिन गुजार गए हैं आर्टिकल 51 DE की तशरीह करना. ये अगर ऐसे कानून बनने लगे जो किसी को समझ ही नहीं आए, और आइन भी किसी को समझ ना आए, और उस पर लंबी चौड़ी तशरीह होना शुरू हो जाए, अगर हम सिर्फ इस पे ही रहे आइन पे, इसमें मुझे समझ नहीं आ रही मुश्किल क्या है समझने की.
मैं तो आपकी बात को थोड़ा आगे बढ़ाता हूँ.
नहीं है क्या मुश्किल इसमें समझने के लिए?
मेरे तो ख्याल में नहीं है, बट आप पेज 20, आप जरा पेज 16 पे चलेंगे सर,
क्योंकि हम बहुत सारे मफरूजों पे जा रहे हैं. देखिए,
मुश्किलात आपके अपने रूल पैदा कर रहे हैं ना आप.
नहीं सर, मैं इसको करता हूँ,
आप रूल को अगर नजरअंदाज कर दें, ठीक है,
ना भी करें,
आईन क्या कहता है, उस अगर वो आईन यूं क्यों बना है और वैसे कैसे बना है, मैंने ना उसको चेंज करना है, ना शायद मेरे हिसाब से तो ये बेहतर होता, तो ऐसे हो जाता, वैसे हो जाता, ये मेरा काम नहीं है
सर.
ये अगर वो, जैसे आपने कहा, ये शिक कई दफ़ा बदलती गई है, एक दफ़ा और बदल लेंगे. नेशनल असम्बली यकीनन सीखती है, नए बदलते जाते हैं ना, ये पैटर्न बेहतर है, वो पैटर्न बेहतर है, ये पैटर्न बेहतर. अब जब भी जो पैटर्न मेरे सामने आएगा, मैं उसी को देखूंगा.
मैं आपको दो रियल एग्जांपल,
मैं अपनी कोई सोच हो, अपना मेरा कोई नजरिया हो, मैं उसको आईन के ऊपर मुंसलिक कर दूंगा जी यूं होना चाहिए, क्योंकि मेरी अकल और दानिश ये कहती है कि मुझे समझ नहीं आ रहा. इतना
कॉम्प्लिकेटेड
वक्त काफी लगा रहे हैं.
नॉट कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, मैं दो चीजें एक्सप्लेन करता हूं.
इतना मुश्किल काम है
तो नॉट कॉम्प्लिकेटेड. मतलब आज की नेशनल असेंबली का भी बता देता हूँ, और आज की
इसमें इसकी रेलिवेंस क्या है, क्या ये होता तो वो होता तो फलना होता.
ये जरा देखिए, ये इस सवाल का रिस्पॉन्स है पेज 16 पे. बलूचिस्तान की आज की एग्जाम्पल लेंगे, जवाब आ
जाएगा. ले रहे हैं एग्जाम्पल
सर, मैं इसलिए ले रहा हूं.
क्या देना चाहते हैं
सर? पॉइंट मैं तो पॉइंट अपना जो दे चुका हूं,
पैटर्न चेंज हो जाए तो हो जाए, हम तो आईन पे चलेंगे ना.
ऐसी
है, मैं लिखा है वो करेंगे. पॉइंट बेशक चेंज हो जाए या ना चेंज हो, मुझे क्या.
पॉइंट आई एम मेकिंग माय लॉर्ड्स इज दैट इंडिपेंडेंस.
हमें ये तो नहीं कहना, अच्छा पैटर्न चेंज होता है तो मैं आईन को चेंज कर देता हूँ.
तो इसकी एक एग्जाम्पल मैं दे,
ये नहीं होने पाया.
मैं इसकी एग्जाम्पल देता हूँ सर, सिंपल एग्जाम्पल.
2018 वाला क्यों नहीं हमें दे?
मैं सिर्फ आपके लिए लेकर आ जाता हूँ.
मैं